بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين محمد وآله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. واعلموا أن فيكم رسول الله، لو يطيعكم في كثير من الأمر لعنتم، ولكن الله حبب إليكم الإيمان وزينه في قلوبكم وكره إليكم الكفر والفسوق والعصيان، أولئك هم الراشدون. صدق الله العظيم. Respected brothers and elders, last week we were speaking about Jabir bin Abdullah رضي الله تعالى عنه, who is the companion of Nabi Kareem صلى الله عليه وسلم. And Jabir رضي الله تعالى عنه's father's name is Abdullah, who is the son of Amr, who is the son of Haram, and the lineage carries on. The father of Jabir رضي الله تعالى عنه was martyred in Uhud. And Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu, after that he participated in all the campaigns with Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And before we finished last week, we mentioned some of the quotations of Jabir bin Abdullah radiallahu ta'ala anhu. We also said that Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu is amongst the mukthirin fil hadith. Mukthirin fil hadith means amongst those companions that has narrated a lot of ahadith. And so I have in front of me the kitab which is called Musnadu Ahmad, Musnadu Imam Ahmad rahimahullahu ta'ala. There is approximately 30,000 ahadith in this kitab. It's in many volumes. And just the ahadith of Jabir bin Abdullah radiallahu ta'ala anhu are approximately 1,200 ahadith. Right? So that's a large number. And generally, you know, those sahaba and companions that narrate over 1,000 or 500 ahadith, they are called mukthirin fil riwayah. So Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu is definitely amongst those people. He spent his whole life with Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam after Nabi alayhi salam migrated to Medina Munawwara. And he himself says that I participated in all the campaigns. So not only was he with Nabi alayhi salam in Medina, but he was also with Nabi alayhi salam when Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam was traveling also. So he is amongst those people that narrated so many ahadith. And Jabir bin Abdullah radiallahu ta'ala anhu was considered when Nabi alayhi salatu wasallam, so like we mentioned that when Nabi alayhi salam, before Nabi alayhi salam migrated, Jabir radiallahu anhu was with his father Abdullah, and they were in the second pledge of allegiance at the hands of Nabi alayhi salam, Bay'atul Aqba al-Thaniya. And it is mentioned that he was a sabi, a child. So I was just trying to work out, and again, this is just an estimate, we don't know 100%, but he was approximately 8 years of age at that time, anywhere between 8 and 9 years of age when he made Bay'at at the hands of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. And from after Uhud onwards, he participated in every campaign with Nabi alayhi salam. So when Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam passed away, Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu, again, was approximately about 18 to 20 years of age. So he was a very young sahabi. He was the likes of Abdullah ibn Umar, Abdullah ibn Abbas. There were many other sahaba that were very young when Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam left the world. So Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu was also one of those companions. And you can imagine all the knowledge that he had learned from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The result of that was that Jabir bin Abdullah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Hisham bin Urwa, who is the son of Urwa bin Zubair. Hisham, who is the son of Urwa. Urwa is the son of Zubair ibn al-Awam, the companion of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And in reference to Zubair ibn al-Awam, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, لِكُلِّ نَبِيٍ رَفِيق وَلِكُلِّ نَبِيٍ حَوَارِي وَحَوَارِي فِي الْجَنَّةِ أَزْزُبَيْرِ. That is narrated by Jabir radiallahu anhu. Jabir radiallahu anhu narrates the hadith. He said, I heard Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying that for every Nabi, Allah Ta'ala has kept a hawari, a very close companion. وَحَوَارِي فِي الْجَنَّةِ الزُّبَيْرِ. And my hawari in Jannat is Zubair radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So Jabir radiallahu anhu narrates this hadith. So it is in reference to Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu that Hisham, who is the son of Urwa, and Urwa is the son of Zubair, who is the companion of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. Urwa was a tabi'i. Urwa was not a sahabi. His other brothers were sahaba, but Urwa was the youngest of the children of Zubair radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He was a tabi'i, which means that Nabi alayhi salam had passed away. But he was also the nephew of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, right? Because Zubair radiallahu ta'ala anhu was married to Asma binti Abi Bakr, and Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha and Asma are sisters. So Urwa was the nephew of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. And Urwa was one of the greatest of scholars of Medina, because the amount of ahadith that he learned from his khala, yani his aunt, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, made him one of the great esteemed personalities of Medina Munawwara. Actually, fuqaha have included Urwa as one of the fuqaha of Medina Munawwara, the jurist. So Urwa is narrating, he's young in comparison to Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He says that Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu had a halaqa in the masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu had a halaqa in the masjid of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yu'khadhu anhu al-ilm. And people would come and learn knowledge from Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Right? So this is the knowledge of Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that he had a halaqa of ilm, of fiqh, of hadith. And people would come to him and they would learn from Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu lived a very long life. Subhanallah. There's one incident Imam Abu Dawood rahmatullah alayhi brings in Kitab al-Wasiyya, or is in Kitab al-Faraid. Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu, on one occasion he became sick. Jabir radiallahu anhu himself says that inni waji'tu. He says that once I became sick, so Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam came to visit me. And when Nabi alayhi sallam visited me, he said I was unconscious. So I didn't know that Nabi alayhi sallam has come. Then Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam made wudu. And Nabi alayhi sallam took some of the water of wudu and he sprinkled it on me. Right? Now ulama say it was either the wudu, it was either from the limbs of Nabi alayhi sallam, or it was the water that he had used. One of the two. Nabi alayhi sallam sprinkled that water on Jabir radiallahu anhu. Jabir radiallahu anhu says, I woke up. I saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu says that I was so sick, I said to Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam that, Ya Rasulullah, I am so ill and I have only sisters. So you can imagine, he was still young at that time. Subhanallah, he never had children, he wasn't even married. But he became so sick that Jabir radiallahu anhu thought that he's going to pass away. So he said to Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that, Ya Rasulullah, I've become so ill and I've got sisters, so how much of my wealth am I allowed to give to other people in wasiyah? And we mentioned last week the incident that his father, Abdullah, had left two gardens. So as the Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu had the two gardens, so he asked Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that, Ya Rasulullah, this is my situation and I've become ill and I think I'm going to pass away. Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam says to Jabir radiallahu anhu, Jabir, I don't think you're going to pass away. Right? Sometimes it happens. A person feels like they're going to pass away. You're so ill. Subhanallah. Allah has written life for that person. And it's amazing that Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that لا يتمنى ين أحدكم الموت لضر أصابه. That let not one of you ask Allah Ta'ala for death because of a difficulty. Don't ask Allah Ta'ala for death, right? Because of some difficulty, because of an illness. Because you don't know what Allah Ta'ala has written. It's highly possible that Allah Ta'ala has written that a person will become well and they'll live for many years after that. So Jabir radiallahu anhu, the same incident happened with him. He said, Ya Rasulullah, how am I going to distribute the wealth? Nabi alayhi salam said, Jabir, you're not going to pass away. Why are you asking me about distributing your wealth? Nonetheless, Allah Ta'ala revealed the ahkam of kalala. يستفتونك قل الله يفتيكم في الكلالة. And kalala is the ahkam of distribution of wealth in mirath for that person whose parents are also not alive, and that person doesn't have children also. And there's a lot of detail to that, but we're not going to go into that right now. So the ahkam of kalala came at that point. Now I was mentioning the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where Nabi alayhi salam said, لا يتمنى ين أحدكم الموت لضر أصابة. Let not one of you aspire for death because of the difficulty that has come upon him. Because you don't know what Allah Ta'ala has written. فَإِنْ كَانَ لَبُدَّ فَاعِلًا. And subhanAllah, so, you know, now Jabir radiallahu anhu is asking this to Nabi alayhi salam. Then ulama say that he lived on after the demise of Nabi alayhi salatu was salam for another approximately between 50 and 60 years. Right? This is, you know, he was ill in the lifetime of Nabi alayhi salatu was salam, but there's different opinions. Some ulama say he passed away in the 60th Hijri, in one of the years of the 60th Hijri. Some ulama say it was the one of the years of the 70th year of Hijrah. And there isn't one date, so it's difficult to say exactly when Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu passed away, but he lived for a long period of time beyond that. So Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that don't aspire for death. فَإِنْ كَانَ لَبُدَّ فَاعِلًا فَلْيَقُولْ اللَّهُمَّ أَحْيِنِي مَا كَانَتِ الْحَيَاةُ خَيْرًا لِي وَتَوَفَّنِي إِذَا عَلِمْتَ الْوَفَاةَ خَيْرًا لِي. Right? Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam said that if a person is going through so much and they are just not able to bear it, whether it's pain, whether it's sickness, may Allah ta'ala protect us all, say ameen. Whatever the case is, and a person feels, I will not be able to go through this, I will not be able to bear this, then Nabi alayhi salam said, then a person should make this dua. But don't ask Allah for death, oh Allah, give me death. No. Say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahumma ahini ma kanatil hayatu khayran li. That, oh Allah, give me life for as long as you know it's good for me to live. As long as it is good for me to live. وَتُوَفَّنِي إِذَا عَلِمْتَ الْوَفَاةَ خَيْرًا لِي. And Wallah, take me away and give me death when you know it's best for me to leave this world. Right? So, Jabir radiallahu ta'ala thought that he's going to pass away. A very similar incident happened with Abu Sa'id Khudri radiallahu ta'ala, also a very long hadith, and we get so much of ahkam from that hadith. But similar incident happened with Abu Sa'id Khudri radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who became sick. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam visited him on the occasion of Fath Makkah. He was sick and he said that, Ya Rasulullah, I feel like I'm going to pass away. How am I going to distribute this wealth that I have? Again, Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam said, لَعَلَّكَ تُخَلَّفَ بَعْدِي. Nabi alayhi salam said that it's an ishara, meaning Nabi alayhi salam indicated that the chances are that you will stay alive after I pass away. Ulama say that Hazrat Abu Sa'id Khudri radiallahu ta'ala anhu, also the after the demise of Nabi alayhi salam, for approximately 40 or 50 years he lived on. Subhanallah. Right? So these are two incidents, and there's other incidents also. So Jabir bin Abdullah radiallahu ta'ala anhu passed away and he was buried in Medina Munawwara. And like I said, that he is amongst those companions and sahaba who narrated many ahadith from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now of course, time does not permit and allow us to go into 1200 plus ahadith of Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So I've chosen, you know, maybe one or two ahadith to speak about with reference to Jabir radiallahu ta'ala. And one of the incidents which I wanted to share last week, but because of shortage of time, I'm going to share that incident today inshallah. So Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu, his father Abdullah had passed away. He had left behind a huge debt that Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu had fulfilled after the demise of his father. Now Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu, on one occasion he was with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They were in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now as they are coming back to Medina Munawwara, as they are returning back to Medina Munawwara, Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam sees that Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu's camel is going very, very slow, right? And this is amazing about the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam. He would be mindful of everybody that is with him. And by the way, the jama'at and the caravans that used to travel at that time was not like, you know, one car going or two car going or five cars going. You are talking about hundreds of people that are traveling together. You know, sometimes it was 1,000, there would maybe sometime 2,000, there would be thousands of people. And so the caravan would stretch out many a times over many kilometers. You know, the beginning of that would be at one point and the end of that caravan would be at another point. But Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam would be mindful of his sahaba. So it is mentioned that Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, he was with Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and he saw that the camel is just lagging behind. It's not moving forward. So Nabi alayhi salam said to Jabir, he said, Jabir, what is wrong with the camel? Say, Ya Rasulullah, this is the situation. The camel is not moving. What am I supposed to do? Nabi alayhi salam said, Jabir, will you sell the camel to me? Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu says that, Ya Rasulullah, you can take it for free. How am I going to sell the camel to you? It's not even worthy of being sold. This camel is not worthy of being sold. Ya Rasulullah, you can take it for free. Nabi alayhi salam says, no, Jabir, you must sell it to me. I'm not going to take it for free. Nabi alayhi salam says, so Jabir radiallahu anhu again, he says, Ya Rasulullah, if you want, you can take it for free. It's no good, this camel. Nabi alayhi salam says, no, I want to pay a price for it. Nonetheless, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam fixes a price for Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And as Jabir radiallahu anhu says that, I said to Nabi alayhi salam that, Ya Rasulullah, sure, no problem. You can take the camel, but I need to get to Medina Munawwara. Right? Or else how am I going to, on foot, I cannot make it to Medina. So Nabi alayhi salam said, no problem. You can ride the camel to Medina. And when we get to Medina, then you can give the camel to me. Now, when Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam arrives in Medina Munawwara, Jabir radiallahu anhu arrives in Medina Munawwara. Jabir radiallahu anhu comes to give the camel to Nabi alayhi salam. Nabi alayhi salam is in the masjid, in Masjid al-Nabawi alayhi salatu wasalam. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammadin abdika wa rasulik wa salli ala al-mu'minin al-mu'minat wal-muslimin wal-muslimat. So Nabi alayhi salam is in the masjid. Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu comes. He wants to give the camel to Nabi alayhi salam. So Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says to Jabir radiallahu anhu that, Jabir, did you enter the masjid and pray two rak'ats? Jabir radiallahu anhu says that, no, I didn't. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says, go in the masjid and make two rak'ats. We learn the adab of the masjid. That whenever you come in the masjid, you should pray the two rak'ats, which is called tahiyyatul masjid. May Allah give us tawfiq. Say ameen. So this is an adab of the masjid. The respect and the etiquette of the masjid. No matter what, according to the Shawafi' and many other ulama, whenever you come in the masjid, and according to Indal Hanafiyya, if it's not a makruh time, if it's not a time in which you are not supposed to pray, for example, after Fajr and Asr, but apart from that, anytime you come in the masjid, salli rak'atayn, to the extent that there's an incident written about a person that came in the masjid. This is in Sahih al-Bukhari, that there was a Bedouin, there was a person that came who was in a very bad situation, you know, very bad position. Nabi alayhi salam looked at his faqr, Nabi alayhi salam looked at his, you know, his difficult situation and told him that, why don't you stand up and make two rak'ats of salah? And this was during the khutbah. So nonetheless, Nabi alayhi salam said to Jabir radiallahu anhu that, did you make two rak'ats? He said, no. Nabi alayhi salam said, enter, make two rak'ats of salah. So tahiyyatul masjid. Whenever we go to the masjid, there's 5 minutes left, there's 2 minutes, well, maybe not 2 minutes, but there's 5 minutes left, or whatever duration of time that we are able to make two rak'ats of mukhtasar salah, we make those two rak'ats. That is the adab of the masjid. Nonetheless, Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu says that I came and then I gave the camel to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nabi gave me the money for that. So Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu says, as I'm walking away, you know, I'm just going, and Nabi alayhi salam calls out for me again. Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu says that I dreaded that Nabi alayhi salam is going to say, Jabir, take the camel, I don't want it, it's not worth anything. So he said, my worst fears were that Nabi alayhi salam is going to say, take the camel. So Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu says, I turned around, but I had this apprehension, I had this fear that maybe Nabi alayhi salam is going to say, look, you know what, I bought the camel, but I don't want the camel, it's not worth anything, it's no good. So when he comes to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Nabi alayhi salam says, Jabir, take the camel and take the money also. Jabir radiallahu anhu says, Ya Rasulullah, but I sold the camel to you, so I can... Nabi alayhi salam says, Jabir, take the camel and take the money also. Right? This is the muhabbat of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, it was during this safar, because Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu says, Laylatul Ba'ir, that during this travel and journey in which Nabi alayhi salam purchased the camel from me, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was with Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu says that Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made istighfar for me 25 times. استغفر لي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم 25 استغفارة. 25 times Nabi عليه السلام made dua to Allah Ta'ala to forgive my sins. And how did that happen? How did it transpire? Subhanallah, it's absolutely amazing. Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu says Nabi Kareem صلى الله عليه وسلم took hold of my hand. And Nabi عليه السلام held my hand, and then my fingers were open. So Nabi عليه السلام said, Jabir, أقضيت عن أبيك دينه؟ Jabir, did you fulfill the debts of your father? Jabir radiallahu anhu says, قلت نعم. I said, نعم يا رسول الله, I fulfilled the debts of my father. Nabi alayhi salam would close one finger and say, يغفر الله لك. Jabir, may Allah forgive you. 25 times, one after the other, Jabir radiallahu anhu says, Nabi alayhi salam asked me repeatedly, أقضيت عن أبيك دينه? Jabir, did you fulfill the debts of your father? I said, نعم يا رسول الله. Nabi alayhi salam would say, يغفر الله لك. Jabir, may Allah forgive your sins. That is the dua that Jabir radiallahu anhu got from Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Respected brothers and elders, that was on the services that Jabir radiallahu anhu did for his father after his father passed away. And that is why Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-abu awsatu abwabil jannah, in shi'ta fahfadha wa in shi'ta fa'adhi'. Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam said, your father is your main entry gate to Jannah. Now if you want, preserve it, look after it, your entry to Jannah will be secure. And if you want, waste it, and you will waste your opportunity to go to Jannah. That was the surface of Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He took care of his sisters. There were 7 or 9 sisters like we mentioned last week. He took care of the debts that his father had left behind. And over and above that, what do we learn from Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu? What do we learn from the dua of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Let us learn to serve our parents. Let us learn to serve our parents. Wallahi, respected brothers and elders, for as long as they are alive, the doors of dua are open. The doors of the duas of one's parents are open. They will make dua to Allah. That's why Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that salatu da'watin la yurad. There are 3 duas that are never turned back by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Da'watul musafir, wa da'watul walid li waladihi, wa da'watul madloom. There are 3 people, Allah never turns the dua back of these 3 people. Number 1, the person that is traveling. And that is why when somebody is traveling, we request them for dua. Why? Because the dua of the musafir is accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when people are traveling, you ask them, make dua for me. And when people are coming back from a journey, you ask them to make dua, number 1. Number 2, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, da'watul walid liwaladihi, the dua of a father for the child. And the dua of a mother for a child. And number 3, da'watul madloom, that person that has been oppressed, Allah Ta'ala does not reject the dua of the mazloom to the extent that Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, وَإِنْ كَانَ كَافِرًا. Even though this person is a non-believer, this person doesn't believe in Allah and His Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, but he has been treated wrong, this person is mazloom, if at that time that person makes a dua, Allah will accept. So that is the power that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept in the du'as of the parents and the services. And to close and finish, one companion came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he said that, Ya Rasulullah, my father and my parents have passed away. So what can I do for them? Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam said that if your parents have passed away, then let me tell you to do two or three things. Number one, Nabi alayhi salam said, make istighfar for them. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive them. So we make dua for all the deceased of the ummah of Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam, that may Allah forgive their sins. Say ameen. May Allah forgive the whole of the ummah of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The young, the old, all those that have passed away and those that are alive. Nabi alayhi salam said, make dua for them. Why? You make istighfar for your parents, Allah will forgive their sins and elevate their statuses, number one. Number two, if they have debts that need to be paid, then fulfill the debts. And number three, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, صِلَةُ الرَّجُلْ وُدَّ أَبِيهِ. That tie, you know, relationship, maintain the ties of relationship your parents had with those people whilst they were alive. They could be family members, or they could be acquaintances, or they could be people that your parents knew and they got along with. You know, they knew them from before they migrated to Canada. Or they were people that they would meet often. Or they used to work together. Or maybe they traveled to Hajj together. There's so many different ways, you know, relationships and ta'alluqat that people have. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, maintain relationship with those people. When you meet them, offer salam to them. Nabi alayhi salam said, do these three things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept these services for your parents. And Allah Ta'ala will forgive their sins and elevate their status in Jannah. May Allah Ta'ala make us amongst those that are obedient to our parents. Allahumma rabbi irhamhuma kama rabbayani saghira. May Allah have mercy on our parents. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala look after them. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prolong their lives. And from amongst us, those whose parents have passed away, may Allah Ta'ala forgive them. And may Allah Ta'ala elevate their status and position in Jannah. أمين رب العالمين وصل اللهم وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. And we make dua to Allah for those that have passed away. May Allah grant them مغفرة, elevate their status in Jannah. And those that are going through difficulty from the ummah of Nabi alayhi salam, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remove their pain and suffering. And those that are sick, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them complete recovery and shifa. And may Allah ta'ala keep us all well. أمين رب العالمين وصل اللهم وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الحمد لله العزيز الحكيم الذي يستدر فيضانه العميم ويستفاض فضله الوسيم نحمده على ما أغرقنا في بحار النعيم وأفاض علينا أهاضيب لطفه القديم ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا مولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله الحرمي العربي الدر اليتيم وإن إبراس الصراط المستقيم على آله وصحبه الذين استنهجوا النهج القويم يا ابن آدم إلى متى في تيه الهوى تهيم وحتى متى تحوم في مفاوز العصيان كالبهيم أتظن أن يترك السدى كل كفار أثيم أفلا يغشاه في الآخرة عذاب أليم أو يغني عنه نصير حميم كلا والله لا ينفع يومئذ صامت ولا ناطق إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم فالنجاة ابن آدم إلى ما يكون جنة من عذاب الجحيم وبلغة إلى جنات النعيم
وباعثا إلى مشاهدة سبحات وجه الله الكريم. فارحموا الصغير ووقروا الكبير وواسوا اليتيم وصاحبوا الوالدين في الدنيا بالتكريم. ولا تنابزوا بالألقاب ولا تمشوا بنميم ولا تتكلموا بكلام الدنيا في المساجد ولا تزكوا نفوسكم عن التأثيم ولا تركنوا إلى الذين ظلموا فتمسكم عذاب أليم ولا يغرنكم نعيم الدنيا فإنه غير مقيم واستغفروا ربكم عن الذنوب فإنه غفور رحيم. وروي في الخبر عن النبي الصادق الأبر أنه قال لا يرمي رجل رجلا بالفسوق ولا يرميه بالكفر إلا ارتدت عليه إن لم يكن صاحبه كذلك. أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم عباد الله جعلني الله تعالى وإياكم ممن فاز بحظ جسيم وتحرف من عذاب يوم عقيم إن أزهر ما يقرأ بالترتيل والتعظيم كلام الله العزيز القديم. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. ولا تلمزوا أنفسكم ولا تنابزوا بالألقاب بئس الاسم الفسوق بعد الإيمان ومن لم يتب فأولئك هم الظالمون. الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا مولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا بين يدي ساعة. من يطع الله ورسوله فقد رشد واهتدى ومن يعص الله ورسوله فقد ضل وغوى. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. إن الله ملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك وصل على المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أرحم أمتي بأمتي أبو بكر وأشدهم في أمر الله عمر وأصدقهم حياء عثمان وقضاهم علي وفاطمة سيدة نساء أهل الجنة والحسن والحسين سيدا شباب أهل الجنة وحمزة أسد الله وأسد رسوله رضوان الله عليهم وعن كل الصحابة أجمعين. الله الله في أصحابي لا تتخذوهم غرضا من بعدي فمن أحبهم فبحبي أحبهم ومن أبغضهم فببغضي أبغضهم وخير أمتي قرني ثم الذين يلونهم ثم الذين يلونهم. اللهم وفقنا لما تحب وترضى واجعل عاقبتنا خيرا من الأولى. اللهم احسن عاقبتنا في الأمور كلها وأجرنا من خزي الدنيا وعذاب الآخرة. عباد الله رحمكم الله أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العلي الجليل يذكركم ادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. أقيموا الصفوف للصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. ووصينا الإنسان بوالديه إحسانا حملته أمه كرها ووضعته كرها وحمله وفصاله 30 شهرا حتى إذا بلغ أشده وبلغ 40 سنة قال رب أوزعني أن أشكر نعمتك التي أنعمت علي وعلى والدي وأن أعمل صالحا ترضاه وأصلح لي في ذريتي إني تبت إليك وإني من المسلمين أولئك الذين نتقبل عنهم أحسن ما عملوا ونتجاوز عن سيئاتهم في أصحاب الجنة وعد الصدق الذي كانوا يوعدون.
الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين تبت يدا أبي لهب وتب ما أغنى عنه ماله وما كسب سيصلى نارا ذات لهب وامرأته حمالة الحطب في جيدها حبل من مسد.
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. اللهم أنت السلام عليك السلام عليك السلام عليك رحمة. اللهم عيني على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادك وبناتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وكنا اللهم توفنا مسلمين ولحقنا بالصالحين ولا خزائن ولا نداما ولا مفتونين. اللهم اشف مرضانا المسلمين وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين. رب اغفر وارحم وتجاوز عما تعلم. صلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين.